We're gonna starve to death up here, Mr. Morgan.
Is everything
okay? We're okay.
We have a few cans of food and a rabbit. For what, 10, 12 people? When I was in the Navy.
I do not wish to hear about what you got up to in the Navy, Mr. Pearson.
We were stranded at sea for 50 days.
And you unfortunately survived.
When we ran away from Blackwater, I wasn't able to get supplies in.
Well, when government agents are hunting you down, sometimes shopping trips need to be cut short. We'll survive. We always have. If needs be, we can eat you. You're the fattest.
I sent Lenny and Bill hunting, and they found nothing.
Well, Lenny's more into book learning than hunting. Bill's a fool. Unless those mountains are full of game that want to read, ain't no wonder they found
nothing. Enough of this. We'll go find something. Come on, Arthur.
Wait a second. Hold on. Here. You're gonna need something to eat out there.
Assorted, salted offal. Starving will be preferable.
Come on, let's go.
You can't go hunting. Look at your hand.
I can't stay here listening to you two. Look, if there's game in those hills, I'll find it. And you can kill it.
You need to rest, Charles.
You think this is rest? Come along. Here, you take this. I can't use it, and you'll have to.
Oh, you're joking.
Use a gun, and we'll scare off every animal for miles around. You're never too old to learn, I imagine. All right, let's head out.
How are you holding up, Charles?
I'm okay, apart from this hand. Stupid mistake.
Still bad?
It'll be fine in a day or two. I just can't pull a bow right now.
I sure hope I can. Never really got the hang of it.
You'll be fine.
So, you reckon we're gonna find something to kill that ain't no Driscoll?
Huh. There's meat up here for sure. Pearson doesn't know what he's talking about. Now the weather's eased off a bit, they'll be needing to feed. We'll head up this way, find some higher ground.
Whew. Been a wild few days, all right. That ride north from Blackwater, getting stuck in the storm, bringing John back in.
You've had a lot put on you. I wish I could have done more.
I didn't mean it like that, just a lot to think back on.
I still don't really know what happened on that boat.
Me neither. Well, Javier told me a bit, but it sure weren't good.
See some of the ground uncovered here. Come on, let's try this way. Keep your eyes peeled for movement. The wind's died down too.
That's good.
No wind at all is bad, but if it's too strong, they won't move. Now shh, stay quiet. Stop here a second. I see something. cold.
There's deer been here. And recently.
How can you tell?
How can you not? We'll track them on foot.
You're gonna need the bow. Don't leave it on your horse. A gun will scare everything around. The bow, Arthur? Come on.
Keep down. Move quietly and slowly. You see the tracks?
I think so. Maybe not.
Focus.
In the snow, but once you get your eye in, you'll be able to track nearly as well in grass and woods.
Shh! Down there! You see him? Are you ready with that bow? Try to hit him in the neck or head. Quick and clean. Get good tension on the string before releasing. Just don't overdo it. Before they move. See if you can get another one. Ah, unlucky. Take your time.
Well done. And I think that's all we can carry.
Okay, you pick up one, I'll get the other.
You sure your hand's okay?
It'll be fine once I get it on my shoulder.
Okay, I'll go grab the other one.
Let's go, boy. Ready to head back when you are.
Come on, then. Let's head back. Nice work, Arthur.
Oh, watch it.
Should be enough meat here to keep us all fed for a few days.
You found him.
I knew you'd be okay with that bow.
It's easier when they ain't shooting back.
We've seen enough of that.
Considering how things were looking a couple of days back, well, maybe our luck is finally on the turn.
Seems to me we should be putting our effort into getting off this mountain now.
Soon. People are still weak, and you've seen how snowed in those wagons are. They ain't going nowhere until we get some more thaw.
You're probably right. And even if we do get off here, what then? We still have a big price on our heads.
This is a big country. We'll find somewhere to lie low. Dutch and Jose will have a plan. Notice how Pearson's had a bottle in his hand ever since we fled Blackwater? We give the camp cook 5 minutes to grab the essentials and go, and he doesn't even bring a crumb of food.
Good that we caught more than one. A lot of mouths to feed.
And that girl from the ranch now, too, but not sure she'll be eating much.
She has a wild look in her eye.
You would, too. She lost her husband, her home, everything she had.
So what do we do with her?
Once we get out of here and we're back on our feet, we'll see. She might have family somewhere.
So it was O'Driscoll's you ran into there?
Yeah. Last thing we was expecting.
What is it with the O'Driscoll's?
You ain't dealt with them? I suppose. Hell, we ain't run into them much the last 6 months. I guess because they've been over this way.
Yeah. I've heard a lot of talk about them.
Well, we've been scrapping over scores with them for years. Big gang. Nasty sons of bitches. Their leader, Combe, and Dutch go way back. And not in a good way. A proper blood feud.
So I heard. Watch out. Bear up ahead. Let's see if we can find another way around. You must be real hungry. Stay well back. Spring storms like this are the worst for animals that sleep all winter.
You and me. How long you been with us now? 5-6 months?
Something like that.
But you didn't expect this.
What?
Any of this. Blackwater mess. Being up here.
Sooner or later, a job's gonna go wrong. Nature of life.
I just thought you might have moved on by now.
You want me to move on?
No. No, not at all. I know you could run it alone, no problem.
I did that for a long time. I'm done with it. Always wondering if someone's gonna kill you in your sleep.
I still wonder that most nights.
I reckon you're okay. This suits me. Sure, I could fall in with another gang, but Dutch. You know, Dutch is different.
Oh, yes. Dutch is certainly different.
He treats me fair. Most of you do. For a fellow with a black father and an Indian mother, that ain't normally the case.
Careful. Well, we need you now.
More than ever. Good. And how long have you been with these boys? Why ain't you run off?
Me? Oh, 20 years, something like that. Since I was a boy.
20 years?
Yeah. He taught me to read. John, too. Taught me a few other things, him and Hosea.
Huh. I'm sure.
Dutch saved me. Saved most of us. That's why we need to stick by him through this. He always sees us right.
How's that new horse?
He's all right. He'll do for now. I appreciate you letting me take Taima the other night.
She's a strong one. It's been as hard on the horses as on the rest of us. I don't know what Dutch would do if something happened to the Count.
Same with Bill and Brown Jack. He's a drunk, miserable bastard, but he loves that horse.
Huh. I hope they all make it.
I tried to ride the Count once. Hucked me faster than a bull. Won't take nobody but him.
It's time over here.
Brought some food back, boys!
It's next to mine. You don't want him running off.
Come on, let's get these over to Pearson.
Thank you for showing me how to use the bow properly.
I only showed you a little. It takes a lifetime of practice to master.
Well, well, well! Just drop it down in here.
What a surprise. Find a camp rat loitering around in the kitchen.
Is that any way to greet an old friend? I feel like we haven't spoken for days.
I do my utmost to avoid
you. Why, he loves me, really. It's his sad way of showing affection.
No, it isn't. Now shoot, get lost.
Well, see you gents later.
See, you got on just fine.
Charles is a wonder.
Have a drink, boys. You earned it. Jesus, what is that? Navy rum, sir. It's the only thing. The only thing. Keeps you sane, it does.
Yeah, oh. Seems to have done a treat on you. You go rest that hand, Charles.
I'll be fine in a few days.
You mind helping me with the skinning, Mr. Morgan? It's easier if we do it together.
I'll get to skin you.
You're always one with the jokes, aren't you? Come on.
This really isn't a job for a man with a burnt hand. I'll see you both later.
You skin that one you dumped on the floor there. Too bad, Mr. Morgan. Yeah. They always said you were a butcher. You know, you could trade these or sell these in pretty much any town. If you're looking to make a legitimate bit of money, of course.
Right now, I'm just looking to get off this mountain alive.
Well, if you catch anything else, you bring it to me.
Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Heck, Arthur Morgan's first decent bit of hunting after all these years.
Yeah. We're on the run now. Everyone's got to do their bit to survive. Just make a good stew. Folk need it. It's been a tough few days.